Today, according to the syllabus, I will discuss three elements. One is the heading, another is paragraph, and another is the deep tag. So, for heading, there are the six levels H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, and H6. And the higher heading numbers indicating a heading of the less importance. Means whenever you are writing the H1, the font size will be big, H2 little bit less, S3 little bit less, like that one up to the S6 means the heading font size is the very very less. And any headings that show their readers the structures of the documents, whenever adding the heading in the web page, so it will show the structure of the your document to the readers. Okay, and that another points of the headings, whenever you are using the headings, either H1, H2, H3, anyone, so next line, next heading will display. So again, no need to write the BR separate one. And the one more point, important point for the heading, based upon the different browsers, the styles of the heading may be the changed. You can see in these pictures, different, share your travels. It is coming here, different, here, different, here, different, here, different. So you can do these changes either with the help of the CSS, okay, and the minor changes again is the applicable through the browser only. Clear? So now we'll see again the one small example of the heading. So what you can do, open the again notepad, you can use any editors, not a problem. So up to the basic HTML5 code you can write here. So written title, you can give any heading. And after the closing the head, you start the body. After this body only, because this part only you want to display on the web page. So I will start from the H1. And then you can write anything. Canara Engineering College. Close the H1. So up to S6 will use for the same text. Then only you can see the effect of the H1 to the S6. H2 again, /H2, closing tag is important. So H3, control V, H3 closing is again important. Then H4, closing again, H4, H5, closing H5. Then you can go for the S6, closing of the S6. Then you can close the body. Then you can close the HTML. Okay, now you can save this file along HTML extension is the HTML only. You can save this file anywhere. I am just saving it the testing.html, and this is the notepad, so use the double quote, so no chance for the .txt extensions. Save the file, and for seeing the output, nothing, you see testing is there already file. Click here, open with, use any browsers. Now it is coming like this only, you see. So first is the H1, second part is the H2, then third, then H4, H5, S6. So S6 is the small, and first one is the H1 is the bigger one. Another thing to see, all H2 again coming to the next line, S3 coming to the next line, again next line, and you see the spacing of the line. That also determined based upon the text. Okay, so this is the one of the advantage for the heading tag, and again this is giving the one of the structures of your again the documents, which is the heading. Heading is always should be bold, now, so you can write like this only. So this is the regarding the heading. So I think this is clear. And one more thing, so under the heading, the H1 and H2, that is called again for the primary and the secondary heading. Okay, and H3 we can consider as a third level of the heading, and H3 font size is the 16 pt, and of course that is the bold one. Okay, so now the next thing regarding the paragraph tag is the P only. So paragraph, you either you want to display the some statement, one line, two line, three line statements, then we can use the paragraph. And multiple line statements, there again if you want to just make any particular word in the different applying the different agenda tag, either the something bold, otherwise strong, that also we can do with the help of the paragraph. And paragraph again we can align in the four way: left, right, justify, and the center. Clear? So this is the regarding the paragraph. Paragraph is again the one of the most popular elements for the web page. So for this purpose, again we'll see the one small example. So same example only we can edit. So this we don't want now. We can go for the paragraph. So you can put here p tag, then again you can write here, this is my text file. Close again the p tag, then again second paragraph again I am taking here, we are from CSC, we are from CEC. Close p, right? Just I am saving this file, same file name only. Minimize, then we can refresh this page. See, so here heading means that is coming bold, here it is not coming the bold. Okay, and you see same again, next paragraph again it will start from the next line only. This is the general practice, whatever you are writing also same way again, if you are using the paragraph it will come under this one. Suppose that CEC if you want bold, okay, CEC if you want bold, so what we can do, so here inside the one minute, yes, CEC is there, you can apply here B and closing of the B here, so B indicate for the bold, right? Control S you can do, then again coming to your output, refresh the PC. It is a little bit bold now. So in this way you can use the paragraph. Now the third is third one, that is called the div elements, div tag. So div elements, if you want to create the partition of your page, means the division of the your page, okay, means the left side one panel, right side one panel, bottom again one panel, top again another panel, and if you want to provide the some other color here and there and something, then we can use the div elements, right? So this is again one of the most important tag for the web application. And if you have a little before partitions, whenever you want to divide something, if your concept is clear, how I want your page layout, right side how much I want width, left side again how much I want again the your margin, size and any properties, that all these things you can set here. So more discussion whenever you look, get the idea about the CSS we can do. So now I'll show you again just three division only, how that divisions tag we can use, okay? And whenever we'll discuss again regarding the CSS, that time you can do the more in more again the style sheet for your divisions. So now you see same file, I remove this paragraph. Now I am making the three divisions. So one div, then we can set the again the height width for this division, then it is good for you to identify. So I'll put the again the inline CSS here again, so I can give inline CSS style equal, that again I'll discuss. This time you just see here for example purpose, height colon giving the 200px. If you are not writing the width, that is by default they will consider your complete screen only. And one more thing, so I'll put here again the color, that is the good for you to identify your division. So background hyphen color colon, I'm just giving any color value here again, the I'm just giving the name only, otherwise you can give the hexadecimal value. Yeah, give hexadecimal value or name give, then easy for you now, because the CSS you don't have any idea now, so that's why, right? So one division and close again the one this tip. DIB. So this is clear. Same way You can copy this one. We'll make again one more divisions, and height will make now the 100 only, and color will make again the blue. One more division. You see, one division again we closing the another divisions. Again we can do. Again this is the 200, and then I am making again the data. So up to this part, opening and the closing one division. Again after that one more division we started. Again after that one more division we started. Right. So you can close this ones and see what is happening here. Other thing is the same only HTML code and see. So 200 first green, 100 is the another green. You can maximize this window. You see 200 first green, another 100 is the another blue one, and again the 200 for the red is the last divisions, right? So in this division, whatever you want to write, you can write. I am writing here again the heading tag here. You can write H1 and writing here CEC, close H1. Another division, but before closing of that division only we have to write. I am writing at the paragraph tag. Paragraph tag CSE department. Close this once P. Then I am writing here again P. Go little bit top. 1 minute. Yes. Then I will write here again the P. Mangalore. Close P. So control S, coming here, refresh. You see, so first one according to the heading, that's why the C is a little bit bold. Here again we put for the paragraph CS department, here this one. So like this one again you can divide the partition, and then again you can see the differences. Now one more thing, if you are writing H1, you see gap is coming. So that is happening due to the H1, because the H1 is again considering for the next line. Na? So that is again gap is coming. This also we can manage. We will not put any space here, that we have to write again the CSS. Clear? So this way you can make the partition of the page. Now inside the one partition, again you can make the one more partition. That is also possible. So in that case you see here first partition only, this is the 200, green part is the 200. So there again I will make the one more partition. So what we have to do after the CEC of this one, again you start the one more div tag, right? And then again you give the height for that division, style colon height colon, I am giving here just 50 px, okay? And each division I will give the width also, a small partition of that division. So colon, you can give here 100 px. So this colon and the semicolon, these are the syntax. That is the part of your inline CSS. I will, that is the part of your syllabus. Again I will discuss. You just keep this point. This is the possible for the division only. Enough. Then close this one and write anything. This is subdivision. I am not writing any again the H1 and any stick. Just simply I am writing this one and close the div part. Okay, so first division is starting here, closing of that division is here. Inside that one again I put one text, and inside that one again I written the one division, and that one again the text part, this part is the text, and again we close this divisions, right? Close as, coming back to your output, double click, you see. So here what happened, color we are not giving, the that's why the problem. So we'll give again color here, background iPhone color colon, will give here again any pink color, pink. Control S, come back, see. So this is again the height and width, only that much only inside that difference. Okay, so you see the code here. First of all you should know how you want your divisions, inside the which division another division, inside which division another division. Then with the help of this only div tag only you can do. So first opening and the closing of division is very very important. So we, here you see first part I want to put again one more division, so I started the this division here of opening, but closing is after the creating the one more division only I close. You see in the code this closing is for the this divisions, and this closing of the division is the first one, main one. Okay, so opening and the closing is the one of the important part to do the division for your web page. I think at least you today you got the idea regarding the heading, paragraph and the divisions. So next video again we'll discuss the next part according to your syllabus. We are just doing all of the video based upon your syllabus one. Thank you for your patience.